A warm welcome to all my dear students. Today, we shall discuss about ratio. What is ratio? It is nothing but a mathematical relationship between two items, and it is expressed in quantitative form. Either it's a relationship expressed in quantitative terms between figures which have cause and effect relationship, or which are connected with each other in some form or the other. We have discussed in previous sessions that the two key methods for analyzing financial statements are horizontal analysis and vertical analysis. That is the first method, and the second method being analyzing financial statement using different types of ratio. So today we shall discuss the ratio. What are the advantages of having this ratio analysis? It helps in forecasting. It's a great managerial tool for interpretation of health of the company. It facilitates communication in the form of numbers and in relation to another. It's a measure of efficiency and it helps in inter-firm comparison. But there are some limitations too. With respect to practical knowledge and interrelationships of the formula. Also, accuracy of financial information and consistency of preparation of financial statement. There is also a time lag between the event and the analysis. Let us look at the classification of ratios. Ratios can be classified with the help of statements, or on the basis of users, or on the basis of relative importance, and ratios based on purpose or function. We shall look at the first type. So looking at the classification of ratios on the basis of statement, so under balance sheet we have many ratios, say for example liquid ratio, current ratio. Similarly, with respect to profit on loss account, we can have gross profit ratio or operating ratio. We can also have balance sheet and P&L account ratios, that is return on investment, return on shareholders fund, etc. If we look at the classification by users, there are many users like management, creditors, shareholders. So these ratios can be also used to look from the viewpoint of each type of group. Say for example, from the point of view of management, the ratios which can be used are operating ratio, return on investment, stock turnover, etc. Similarly, ratios for creditors can be current ratio, solvency ratio, debt equity ratio, etc. Ratios for shareholders are return on shareholders fund and payout ratio. The next classification being classification based on relative importance, namely primary ratio, secondary performance ratio, secondary credit ratio, and growth ratio. If we look at primary ratios, example can be return on capital employed. Secondary performance ratio example can be working capital turnover ratio or stock turnover ratio. Secondary credit ratio can be creditors turnover ratio, liquid ratio. And growth ratio can be growth rate in sales or net asset. If you look at the classification based on by purpose, the purpose can be to understand profitability, a turnover, a short-term solvency or a long-term solvency. So these can be example are profitability ratio example, return on investment or net profit ratio. Turnover ratio example can be stock turnover or debtors turnover. And short-term solvency ratio can be current ratio or liquidity ratio. An example of long-term solvency ratio can be proprietary ratio or debt equity ratio. It is an excellent tool even to understand financial statements for non-finance managers. While financial statement analysis is an excellent tool, there are several issues to be aware of, that primarily being compatibility between periods. The company preparing the financial statement may have changed the accounts in which it stores financial information, so that results may differ from period to period. Compatibility between companies. An analyst frequently compares the financial ratios of different companies in order to see how they match up against each other. However, each company may aggregate financial information differently, so the ratio result may not be conclusive. Financial analysis only reviews a company's financial information. It does not concentrate on operational information. Hence, operational information being a key indicator of future performance is ignored. Thus, this may not give a true picture. So, dear students, this is about a small synopsis on ratio analysis. We shall have a look at in-depth analysis in our next session. Thank you.